are worthy to be praised. You are the Most High God. You are the Alpha and Omega. Without you, we are nothing. We worship you, my Lord. We give you all the glory. We commit our lives into your hands this morning. We are just an empty vessel standing before you this morning. We are praying to you that fill us with your Holy Spirit. Let your words that are about to reach your children stay in our lives, so that whenever we get out there, we will be able to send the message that you have laid on our hearts. And indeed, we have been able to preach the gospel as you want us to preach it. Most of the time we hear the word, and within the shortest possible time, it disappears from us. This time, we are praying to you that do not let such a thing happen to us. Let it stay in our hearts so that we can live with it the rest of our lives. We thank you in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. This morning, my message is titled The Message and My Life, or The Message and Your Life. You know one thing, if a child goes to school after a period of time, he needs to write an exam to prove to his teachers or to the world that whatever he has or she has learned is still what in him or her. As Christians also, we do the same thing. We always come to church, learn the word of God. At a point in time, God had to let us prove it out for everyone to know that yes, the message that we have what we have acquired in us is still in us. That is why this month, our church, your church, my church, has set this month aside that we are going out to prove to the world that the message that we have learned here is not meant for we alone, but you have to be able to share with others. Is your life going inside with the message? There are certain trenches in our lives that we need to straighten before we get out there. If not, it will be very difficult for you to preach the word of God outside. The task that we are taking, you might see it very easily, but it's not easy. It's very, very difficult. There are some people, you approach them, they don't even give you the room to even speak. Sorry, I'm busy. If you are not careful, you'll be shy, and that shyness can put you off for the whole year. If you are bold, within a second, you say, oh, it's nothing, because it's bound to happen. There are some, you get there, as soon as you start your message, tell them, oh, is this what you are saying? I know. And it's true, they know more than, you know, only that they don't want to practice it. So let us try as much as possible that we will not be overconfident going out there. We will not be too much blabbing, but only we pray that what God has laid on our hearts will go out at that time. There's one thing, today happens to be the most special day. I don't know if you have noticed it. Today's date is 10th. The month is 10th. The year is 10th. Have you seen it?
Yes.
10, 10, 10. Throughout. This is to tell you that God has something for you. And today happens to be a Sunday, a day that you have set aside for God.
Yes.
And that same day is the day that you know, or the same month is the month that you know that you have to go out to preach. Let that thing be the strength of you. That at least this day you have what? Met it. You don't see the volume of it, but you don't see it again. You meet a lot of times in the month, a lot of times in the days, a lot of times in the year, but you are not going to meet exact same day on Sunday like this. So please, the message which we are about to share today, keep it in your heart so that when you go out there, you'll be able to use it, or it will serve as a fortune. When you are deviating, you know, and then it will guide you. Shall we open our Bible to the Gospel according to Luke? Luke chapter 6. We are going to read from verse 43 and end at verse 45. Today we are going to take only three chapters, and all is in Luke. From there we go to Luke chapter 11, 33 and 36. And lastly, we go to Luke chapter 14, 34 and 35. These are the three chapters I want us to read. I take Luke chapter 6, verse 43 to 45. A healthy tree does not bear bad fruits, nor does not a poor tree bear good fruits. Every tree is known by the fruit it bears. You do not pick a fig from a thorn bushes, or gather grapes from bramble branches. A good person bring good out of the person. A bad person bring out the treasure of his bad things. For the mouth speaks what the heart is full of. This is what I want us to relate our lives to. This is not only 3 years for us to write our exams. I know those who do medicine spend about 7 years and above, architecture 7 years and above, other courses 3 years, and you become a graduate or what do you call it? You get a certificate if you pass out well. But our own is more than that 3 years. Calculate, when did you become a Christian? The amount of messages that you have heard up to now, this is the time you are going out. And Luke is telling you and I that there wouldn't be any fruit or any tree that will bear a fruit which is not a kind of that tree. If you love mango, I don't think you go under a pawpaw tree and then you go and look for mango over there. No. But these days, in Christianity, when you go to church, that's where you find the opposite of what Luke is telling you and I. You get to a church, you find thieves over there. You find robbers over there. Gossips, liars, jealous, all these kind of things are found there. Why? Is it the work of the scientists to take an orange tree, add a lemon branches to it, so that one tree will be producing lemon at the same time, orange at the same, with the same, what do you call it, tree? No. But we have proved ourselves as scientists. We come together to listen to the word of God. Our attitude does not reflect to the message that what we are listening. If you find three people gossiping, at least two of them will be Christians. Why? Is that the fruit that you are bearing? Is that the message that you are carrying? No. We are telling ourselves that a good tree does not bear a good fruit. But as Christians, the message that came into us is what's supposed to come out in a bunch. Like you put a grain of, let's say, wheat or sorghum or corn in the air. For some months time, it will not bring out only one grain out. A lot. That if you want to continue to grow that same quantity, you're going to get in bags. But we put one there, hide ourselves, go and take that same one from the ground, and we turn to say that God did not allow our seed to germinate, forgetting that we ourselves are taking it. You are going out, or we are going out to preach. What message are you carrying? Is it with the time that you take a beer, a score, or whatever it is, outside there, drink it for everyone to be like, yes, you know how to drink. And you standing there drinking at that same time, you are just standing there telling somebody that don't drink. How is the person going to tell you? Or how is the person going to look at you? This is something that Christians, we should try. Not only that, our lifestyles. As a Christian, we have a dressing code. As a Christian, we have the way to speak. As a Christian, everything about us is very, very unique. But we are allowing the devil to corrupt all those kind of things. These are the things God gave it to you that the devil is envy of it and taking it away from you. brothers and sisters, let us try as much as possible that at least the message that we have heard, even if you take a verse and let that verse reflect in your life, I tell you, well, there will be no need for us to go out saying that we are going to preach. Because even the way you calculate your steps is already preaching to others. Most of us are foreigners. We found ourselves in a land which we don't know or we are not used to their culture. If you ask me to go out to preach, I prefer preaching to a Ghanaian. Because I will get so many examples to tell that person and he will understand me. I believe if you're a Nigerian, you'll be preferring speaking to a Nigerian. If you're a Filipino, you'll do the same thing. If you're a Maltese, you'll prefer speaking to what? A Maltese. But this is the time that is not what God asks us to do. In Christianity, there is nothing like barbarism. Whether you're a Jewish, a Ghanaian, African, European, nothing. We share one faith, one hope.
Hallelujah.
If you get out there, don't think that. It's true, when you look at faces, you know that yeah, this person is from Africa, or this person is from Asia, this person is from US. Forget about that. Just avoid the person. At least, if you're able to let the person know that yes, Christ loves you, there are so many things for you. If we want to be jealous, let us be jealous of something good.
Hallelujah.